Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you're having a great day. And as always, thanks to everybody that's subscribed. So my apologies, I've got a bit of a cold today. So yeah, hopefully it won't affect me too much. I've got a sore throat and blocked nose. And I'm really looking forward to getting back to this album. So this is a track I'm gonna react to. It's from Out of the Blue by the Electric Light Orchestra. It's called Jungle, and I really enjoyed some of the tracks from Concerto for a Rainy Day, and I accepted the criticism that it was something to be listened to altogether. I haven't quite got around to listening to Mr. Blue Sky yet, but of course I know that track, but it'd be nice to maybe have a listen to the whole lot and and then see how that feeds into Mr. Blue Sky at the end. So yeah, this is a standalone track, I think, on the album. It's Jungle, and not sure what side this was on, actually. So ELO consists of Jeff Lynne on vocals, Bev Bevin on drums, Richard Tandy on keyboard and piano, Kelly Grucott on guitar, Mick Kaminsky on violin, and Hugh McDowell on the cello. So without further ado, this is the Electric Light Orchestra with Jungle. just to add, this is a recording that's been taken from, I think, vinyl. So it's been recorded into digital maybe, but hopefully it'll have the snap, crackle and pop of a vinyl record. We will see. Oh, it feels very Egyptian. Quite an exotic start to this song. Tarzan? Sorry to pause it, I had to cough actually. So I do know now that this is taken from side two of the album, and it was the third track on side two. And what I really love so far is the percussion on this, and it feels very, there's a lot of percussion going on, I think. I like the little vocal interludes as well. I heard a little bit of start just now, and the harmonies as well, it's great to hear them. And I thought it might be like another string orientated song, but the strings came in at the very beginning and they've sort of since left us a bit. Yeah, so really enjoying this song so far. It feels a lot different to the other tracks I've heard from this album, especially the Concerto for a Rainy Day, obviously World West Hero, and The Sweet Talking Woman, which I haven't reacted to, but I do know. So yeah, this feels like it's a bit of a departure from that, and they're having a lot of fun with it. So let me just take that back a little bit. Yeah, Well, so that was an ending. I think am I to believe then by that ending with the alarm clock going off that this was some kind of dream? Possibly. And I loved the energy of this. I could almost be dancing to this if I didn't have a bad knee. But I love the energy to this and all the harmonies. There's like a little bit of it's almost like a church choral bit just right at the very end. There's so much going on in this, and the percussion was fantastic all the way through. Had that beat to it as well. I'm not sure exactly what they were trying to portray in this, whether it was just this idea of maybe having a wild dream about a different place, a different time, and then at the end you're rudely awoken by the horrid alarm clock. So I'm going to dive straight to the lyrics, I think, and see if there's any other meaning to this other than just a purely fantastic dream. I was standing in a jungle, I was feeling all right. I was wandering in a darkness in the middle of a night, more humming. The moon began to shine, I saw a clearing ahead. But what's that going on? I think I'm out of my head. Ah, chugga chugga hoo la lay. Just love the way they just decided to throw that in. All the in-depth lyrics, the deep meaningful lyrics that ELO come out with, and they throw in a chugga chugga hoo la lay into the mix. Looka looka coo la lay. 100 animals were gathered round in the night, and they were singing out a lovely song under the pale moonlight. I stood and stared for quite a while, then a lion sang to me and smiled, "Come and join us if you so desire." I said, "Now please explain the meaning of this song you sing." And it's wondrous, it is our great blue ship that sails around a mighty sun, and joy to everyone that rides along. And they danced pretty soon, I knew the tune, and we sat and sang under the moon, and the jungle rang in joyful harmony. Wondrous is our great blue ship that sails around. So it does actually feel like some sort of weird, trippy dream, this does. With talking animals, animals gathering in the jungle, big blue ships. It was wonderfully done, and I remember reacting to a Genesis song. I think it was, what was it? It's not All in a Night's Dream. It was something like that, Scenes of a Night's Dream. And it had a kind of same sort of feel to it, but that was for a child. I think this is for somebody that is clearly an escape from their mundane life of having to get up at a certain time in the morning, go to work maybe, go to school, and come back and had a really colourful dream. I love dreams. Most of the dreams I can't remember, but they say the ones you do remember are the ones that have some sort of real life meaning and portent to them. So I don't necessarily write my dreams down, but I might mention them on social media because so I've got a record of that dream, and when it comes around, I'm thinking, God, what must I have been eating before I went to sleep that night to have such a vivid and funky dream? I don't really have much more to say about this. Obviously, all songs written by Jeff Lynne, and really fun lyrics. And they must have had a lot of fun creating this track, and I can imagine them all in a recording studio with lots of different bits of percussion, you know, and then you'd have like you have your tambourine, you've got your maybe your maracas, and just all of this like vast array of knickknacks that they can play, create the sounds on. And yeah, I was kind of surprised that the strings weren't prevalent. They sort of came in and they left the room just a bit like the cat, and they left it to mainly percussion. And that does feel appropriate if you're singing about jungle, maybe the drums and, you know, the stuff like that. So yeah, I really enjoyed this. Felt very different to the rest of the tracks that I've heard so far. I will get round to reacting to all the other tracks. I'm just having a look actually at the back of, so we've got Sweet Talking Woman, Across the Border, Night in the City, Starlight, and then Jungle, Believe Me Now, Stepping Out. Then we've got the Concerto for a Rainy Day. Then we've got Sweet is a Night for Whale, Birmingham Blues, Wild West Hero. I wonder if Birmingham Blues is about Birmingham, because that's where Jeff Lynn comes from. I don't know. So anyway, let me know what you think of this track, and excuse me having, like, it's really yampy cold that I've developed. And yeah, join me in the comments below. Love to hear your thoughts on this. So till next time, take care of yourselves. Have a great day, great week.